Om et øjeblik skal vi se en film, som hedder Unge Israel, der er optaget af nogle forhenværende gymnasieelever fra Nørre Gymnasium. Susi og Eva blandt andet. Susi, hvorfor har I egentlig optaget den film?
Det var lidt ligesom også for at få noget med hjem fra Israel. Det var en studietur, vi var på. Og så i stedet for måske at skrive en kedelig tør rapport, når vi kom hjem, så kunne det være meget skægt at prøve at filme. Og så har vi haft film i skolen, og så synes vi, det kunne være meget sjovt at prøve det.
Det vil sige, I har optaget det med skolens grej?
Ja, det er skolens udstyr, det hele.
Mm-hmm. Og Eva, havde I lang tid til det?
Ja, nej, det havde vi ikke. Det var ikke hovedformålet med turen. Det var bare et biprodukt.
De mennesker, de unge, I interviewer i Israel, det virker lidt som om, I kender dem godt. Gjorde I det?
Ja, altså vi boede hos unge jøder, som vi var placeret ud hos, og vi lærte dem ret godt at kende. Altså dem, vi synes formulerede sig bedst, og som havde nogle spændende meninger, dem greb vi så fat i og interviewede.
Men I havde problemer med at komme ud til palæstinenserne, fordi der er kun én, der er med her i filmen. Og han er med på Dias. Hvordan kan det være?
Ja, altså det må vi lige forklare, selvfølgelig. Vi var kun i én palæstinensisk landsby, og det var med meget kort varsel, fordi vi var mest blandt jøder. Og de der unge jøder, de havde ikke nogen arabiske venner. Så det var fuldstændig improviseret. Og
Men I havde heller ikke grejet med, Susi?
Nej, det var det. Altså, vi vidste ikke. Vi vidste heller, om vi måtte overhovedet interviewe nogen. Så det var noget, vi lige pludselig fandt ud af. Og det var et helt tilfælde, at vi havde båndoptageren med. Det var sådan en lille en, og man kunne også høre, at lyden er ikke så god. Og det er meget uheldigt, at han fremstår som på den måde kun på billedet, og så stammer han også lidt. Og det er vi kede af, men altså, det var ikke meningen, at han skulle komme i et ufordelagtigt lys. Altså, det var ikke meningen med det. Men det kunne ikke være anderledes. Altså, som sagt, det var jo ikke derfor, vi tog derned. Så ville vi have planlagt det bedre.
Jamen, lad os se filmen.
Israel er et ungt land, ikke engang 40 år gammelt. Landets historie har været præget af krige og fjendtlighed med de omkringliggende arabiske lande. Israel er et lille land, på størrelse med Jylland og med en befolkning på ca. 3,5 millioner jøder. Hertil kommer ca. 600.000 israelske araber med israelsk statsborgerskab. Som følge af seksdageskrigen i 1967 besatte Israel følgende områder, som er markeret med gul på kortet. Golanhøjderne mod nord, Vestbredden mod øst og Gazastriben mod sydvest. De besatte områder er ikke indlemmet i staten Israel, men administreres militært. I de besatte områder bor ca. 1,5 millioner arabere. Israel er kontrasternes land. Landskabsmæssigt. Måden at bo på. Thank you. og religiøst. Vesten og Orienten. Også befolkningsmæssigt. Vi har talt med nogle israelere for at finde ud af, hvordan det er at være ung i et land, der er præget af disse modsætninger, og som er et politisk brændpunkt, hvor krige og terrorisme er en del af dagligdagen. Vi har talt med fire piger fra en 3.G-klasse på Danmarksskolen i Jerusalem, to drenge fra samme skole. De er emigranter fra Sovjet og kom til Israel midt i 70'erne. To unge fra en kibbutz i Nordisrael, samt gymnasieeleven Abed fra en lille arabisk landsby.
I'd like to ask you, you have got such a lot of problems in your country, and you have always terrorism, and you can go into the army. And maybe you have to go to a war in a few years. You don't know that. Are you afraid of all these things?
I'm afraid of war very much. I believe. It's a very stupid nature of man to go kill his brother, go kill another person, because it doesn't solve anything, you know. And I am scared of this, because you never know so many ugly things about war.
In Israel, it is an important duty is to go to the army, because it's because of this situation, very bad situation. In the Middle East, we can fight and to win, but it will not finish the wars. It will be another wars, and so I don't think the wars it's the solution for this crisis. It's my opinion, but I think if I go to army and they will say to me, You have to do it. I will do, because I'm a soldier, and I have to do what they told me.
As I was a child, I was brought up like that. I knew that I'm going to serve the army, and somehow it became natural for me. And I all the time thought that it's important, and I have to do it for 2 years, and.
I think about the things because they're near my home, as you say. But I'm not afraid because I think I'm not afraid because I didn't feel it yet. I hope I won't feel it on my flesh. But maybe I got used to it, because from when I was a little girl, I live with these things and I hear them every day. And I hope I wouldn't, but this is a fact, and I think I'm getting used to it, and that's a bad thing.
What do you feel about the Arabs? Are you afraid of them?
Depends because if I know the man that I speak with him, so I don't afraid. But if I see an Arab in the street, I'm afraid because I don't know. Maybe he wants to kill me. I don't know what he's saying, so I'm afraid. It's not say that all the Arabs, it's the murderers and killers. I think Arabs want peace, only people want to war, but a much of Arabs, many Arabs want a peaceful solution. But I have to be afraid because I don't know if this man want to kill me or no.
The people like all of us, and They don't have horns on the head.
You sure?
I'm sure. But of course, somehow it comes that we are enemies, and it doesn't mean that each people is not a human being. It just means that the politics is so, and
I'm afraid to go in the, for example, in the old city. It's very now it's very dangerous. I hate Arab because they do very very terrible things. They kill us, the girls and the soldier and the children, little children, and bombs. You know what I mean, bombs?
Yeah, of course.
All day the bombs in places in Jerusalem, in Jaffa, in Tel Aviv. No, it's very. I'm very afraid from this because I'm afraid that it will be a war.
It's the terror. It's come up and up, and you know, in here it's two bodies they found and two bodies found here, so it's very scared. It's very, you can't go to work without to take with you the feeling that you are today, maybe you don't come home again or something like that. You understand me?
Yeah.
There's some good Arabs and there's some bad Arabs, like any people.
Do you have Arab friends?
Yes, I do have a few. They're just normal people.
Do you think you could ever marry an Arab boy?
I don't think so. Quite not.
Absolutely.
No,
sure.
Absolutely.
Why not?
Because they have a sort of life. Their sort of life is very different from us. And I believe in God. And God tell us how we keep our religion.
Mm-hmm.
When we marry, with Jewish, and not mixing with the Arabics or the
things,
something like this. Mm-hmm. This is our specialness.
You would never.
We have at least to keep this thing.
You would never marry one from my group, one of those blonde
guys. No, I don't think so. Even they're blonde and they have a great body.
No, you wouldn't do that?
No.
But would a Jew from Denmark be good enough?
Not good enough, but
Jew, yeah. Yeah,
the main
why not? He's handsome, blonde.
I think it's very important that not to being the Jew, but to have a Jewish state, because if you live in Russia, you're one of many nations, a lot of nations, and so the people can in Russia, you can walk in the street, and the people will say you are Jewish, and it's not good. They think it's not good in many times, and in Israel it's only one Jewish state that you can to think that you like the other people, you don't different from him from some reasons. You understand?
In this country, we live in this country. We have a lot of lost in those days, especially, but we have to take it. We have to fight against it, but we have to live here, because if we are not, the Arab will get our place, and we lost our country that in the Bible God give it to us.
Does religion means anything to you?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I'm not religious, but I do believe in God, and I do think Judaism is beautiful. Religion is beautiful. I myself think it's a miracle that Israel did become a state after all that has become of the Jewish people for the past 2,000 years.
I don't feel as as something special because I'm a Jew.
I Danmark forbinder vi ofte Israel med det kollektive landbrug kibbutzen. De fleste bor dog i store byer som Jerusalem og Tel Aviv. Men selvom kun ca. 3% af Israels befolkning bor i kibbutzen, spiller den en særdeles central rolle. Såvel økonomisk, fordi kibbutzen indbringer landet en stor del af dets eksportindtægter, som politisk, da der i parlamentet Knesset sidder mange med tilknytning til kibbutzbevægelsen. Og endelig har kibbutzmedlemmer traditionelt også udmærket sig inden for militæret.
What do you think about living in a kibbutz? Do you like it?
I think for children it's beautiful. It's a paradise. Such a warm environment and close. But for people our age, it's you need to get out and see people, see things. At our age, it's best to leave the kibbutz and come back. I believe when I grow up, I want to live on a kibbutz, have children here.
It's a good place to live. It's nice and beautiful and quiet.
You go to work, you do your work and nothing else. No supermarket and no bank. Not all of that junk.
Why? Why do you think it's junk?
Why? I think all the running around is not necessary. You know, here your laundry is done, your food is cooked. You know.
Don't you think it would that it makes you too dependent on so many other people?
No. It's a commune. Everybody helps each other. Everybody, you know, puts whatever they can do. They do it. And if, for instance, something happens to me when I'm young, I'll be taken care of for the rest of my life.
Do you think it's good raising the children in children houses?
I think they study to be much more independent. And I think they study from very young age to help other people and to be aware of what they want.
I grew up in a children's house. It's quite nice. There's advantages and disadvantages. Advantages, you're with your friends all day and you're away from your house. You can concentrate more and studying and everything. But disadvantage, you're away from your family. You're only with your family half of the day.
But what do you think about they want to change it now? Do you think it's a good idea?
I was convinced that it is a good idea. I think a child, when he's young, he should be with his parents during the night time and in the evening, just being alone with a father and mother.
I liked to be in a children's house. It's very fun and make parties at night and do many things together. But I think if my children will sleep at home, they will lose it. But maybe there are other things which are important. I think it's better to the parents that to the feeling of the parents that the children sleeps at home, more than the feeling of the children.
In kibbutz, do you think there are equal rights among men and women?
I think there are equal rights, but I think that the first idea was to make it really equal. I mean, that the girls will do exactly the same works as men. And I think somehow it's not like that, because the women are more, they don't work in agriculture or other physical work works. They prefer work with to work with children and more quiet works, and somehow it became like that. But maybe it also shows that is the natural of the people.
Do you think that is good, or do you want to change it?
Me myself, I think that I would like to work in agriculture.
I det israelske parlament, Knesset, er mange partier repræsenteret. De sidste års meget urolige forhold i Mellemøsten har dannet grobund for yderliggående grupperinger både på højre og venstrefløjen. Den stærkt højreorienterede rabbi Maria Kahane er et eksempel herpå. Kahane har for eksempel ytret sig racistisk om de israelske arabere. Ifølge en undersøgelse foretaget i sommeren 1985 har 40% af den israelske ungdom sympati for hans holdninger.
I'm afraid of any people in which fanatics can be found. I'm very much afraid of fanatism on every side. On the Israeli side, there are religious fanatism, fascist fanatism, and I can't accept it. It's very frightening.
How come do you think that such a lot of young people vote for Kahane?
I think they need a strong man. Young people always look for force. Not always, but a lot of young people look for force. And I think Kahane, I think he's a madman, but I think Kahane is he's always talking about force, and I will kill them, and I will take them, and I will do that. And young people believe him, and young people like the force. Not all the young people, but a lot of them are very attractive to the power and all the things that are not right.
He's absolutely terrible. First of all, he wants to eliminate democracy. He's against all the Western values. He says that Zionism and democracy don't go together. That democracy has to be destroyed in Israel, and then it'll be absolutely awful to live here under a dictatorship. He's being very militant, and young people like militancy, like a strong leader, and he seems to be a strong leader. But he is not really a strong leader. He's not a leader at all. He's some kind of a mentally disturbed person who came here from the United States and was elected to the Knesset.
He promised him no terrorists, clean country, work all the problems out, you know? It's very promising.
I want to live with Arabic with peace, but there's some sources of Arabic, like Arafat or PLO, that you can't, it's impossible to live with them. They're living, their view of thinking is always to kill. The Jewish people mustn't live. They must go from the world. We want to live. But when we can't live with those sorts of people, we have to do something about them. And this is, I'm not in the side of Kahane, but I think too, he's a madman, but something in his thought is true.
How do you like PLO?
How do I like them? Yes. I don't like them. I feel violence doesn't solve anything. And fighting each other, especially the way they do. If they want to fight, okay, fight like men, you know, don't kill women and children, innocent people.
You have to be in their shoes to understand how they feel. Anyway, innocent people have nothing to do with that. I mean, you can't just go and shoot them. It's not a solution. I want to point something that all the acts of PLO are directed against innocent people who are not even armed, not against the army.
There's no way to fight, only politics. I believe there is a solution. You can come to a solution. somehow with politics.
The terror shows that who is doing the people who are doing it, they're afraid, because otherwise they would come and war face to face.
I believe Palestinians have a right. They have a right to live in Israel. But not with any forces, no bombs, no guns.
The Palestinians think that the leader of the Palestinian nation is a PLO. So if you want to talk, we have to talk with the leader of Palestinian nation, and it is PLO. And so I think we have to speak with them.
I think the PLO has mostly one thing in common, and then their hatred to Israel and the will of them to have a country of their own in Israel. And of course there are a lot of streams in the PLO, many, many, many. And I think first they should have one opinion, and then we could talk.
Der er mange meninger inden for PLO og blandt araberne. Vi har talt med en ung araber, der bor i en landsby i det nordøstlige Israel, for at få belyst fra en anden synsvinkel nogle af de samme spørgsmål, som vi talte med de jødiske gymnasieelever om.
What do you think you are first?
I'm just nine. I'm second, I'm Arabic. And third, I'm Israeli.
You're afraid of the Jews?
Not all of them. I afraid if I was alone in, for example, in Tel Aviv, I afraid from people who likes Kahana or don't who hates Arabic.
Does Arabs in Israel vote to Knesset?
Yes.
What does your family vote?
Most of them vote. To Shimon Peres.
Labour.
Yeah.
Why doesn't they vote to the Arab Party?
Because they are fools. They don't know what they're doing. For example, they want to live. They want to make a country for Jewish. For Jewish and Arabics together, yeah, and the Jewish don't want to live with them.
How can you vote to Shimon Peres, who is a Zionist?
Because the most man that he likes Arabic. He don't likes, but he don't want to kill us as Kahana, as Shamir. Kahana, for example. He doesn't want us in this country. He wants to do that fast. Okay, but the other people, they want to make that slowly.
What do you think about the PLO and Arafat?
I think Arafat. I love this man. I think he's a genius, and all, I think all of his ideas is right.
What do you think about him or his group killing children, women, people, innocent people?
They don't have any other solution.
If one day there would be a Palestinian state at the West Bank, then would you move to the West Bank?
No, I don't. I will stay here forever. I will never leave this country. I born here, and I like this place, and I have many friends here. And many Jewish friends.
Have you ever had a Jewish girlfriend?
I have a girl, a Jewish girl friend, but she but we stopped that relationship between us because she began to flirt from me. You know, one day she told me that she felt that I will rape her. I will rape her. You understand?
Why do you think she was afraid of you?
She told me that. She began to tell me that the Arabic is bad people, and she hates Arabic, and I began to understand that she don't want to continue with me.
Personally, have a solution to the Middle East conflict? Do you think it'll end?
Solution?
Yes. Do you think the Middle East conflict will go on, or do you think
it will stop?
It'll stop the peace with the Arabs?
I think it will be very, very hard because we have to pay for this a lot. We have to give from our country to them for a peace, and it's hard to give up. To surrender.
The West Bank, though, also includes Jerusalem. And I wish we could give up Jerusalem knowing that it would be a neutral territory where both nations could share and live together and everything. I have a feeling, though, that they will bring army into there and keep us out, and we'll have a whole new war again. But the West Bank, I feel, should belong to Palestine, Palestinians, or Jordan, or whatever you want to call it.
I think they should have a country also. Because it's not that they're only civilians. They feel like people, that they should live in a country and have a government and all sorts of things. And live their life, and not be under other control. I think it has to be in the West Bank, and Gaza, that place, and most of the Arabs are there. And I don't think that they should have. An army of themselves, because it's very hard. Then it would be a big threat for us if they would have an army, and it's very close, of course, to Israel. And
do you think the Arabs would accept your solution?
I don't know.
Do you think the West Bank and Gaza and Golan, do you think they belong to Israel?
The what? The Golan and?
Golan, West
yes,
Bank.
Yes, of course.
The Golan,
yes.
I see.
The best solution, for my opinion, is that all those Arabs will go to Jordan, because I think Jordan is a country without people. I mean, all of the people that live in Jordan are, most of them are Bedouins, and I think the people of Jordan is the Palestinians, and that would be a great solution, but it's hard because Hussein doesn't want it.
The Arab nation, when they begin at the wars, they want to destroy the state of Israel. It was the only they want, and today in the Arab world, it's you see as countries like Jordan and Egypt that want a peaceful solution. But you have another countries like Syria that think that that the war is only one solution, and to destroy the state of Israel is only one solution. So I think it's many kinds of Arab countries and different opinions of their leaders.
The people who don't like peace, who don't want peace to come to this area, and they're on the both sides. The Israeli and the Arab side.
There won't be a solution because the Arabs have this thought of their man, and they get that and they give it to their children. A children, if you see a girl taking an RPG and shooting our soldier, a children, a 12 years old, this kind of thought is in their blood. You can get it out.
I want to be a beast in the Middle East. Because if it will not be a beast, the killing will continue, and the Jewish will kill the Arabic, and the same thing, the Arabic will kill the Jewish. I don't know so much about history, and I know that we can live in the same country. We and the Jewish, they have the right to live here. And we also, we have the right to live in this country.
It has to be the Jewish state. And the Jewish state, it has to be Israel. But we have lands that we don't occupy it, that it's us, our lands, you understand? I think that only the lands that we occupy it, we have to back it to the Arabs, because in the other case, I don't see a peaceful solution coming.
It's my country, and I like it.